in the game, cause see the boxing boys. Welcome back, gang, for the first time and hopefully many more to come. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel and click on the notifications right here, this little bell, so you can get those emails every time we go live. Peace.
I've never listened. Put it this way, I'm better than you in every single way. In terms of, put it this way, show one time, everyone keeps talking about power versus skill. What time have you in your pro or even amateur career have you outclassed somebody? I've never seen one time. The time everyone talks about, we picked you up, your shoulder came out, and you rallied through and straight through with what you came out to, who never even passed Southern Area level. You went toe to toe with Russell Henshaw, who then showed himself to be just another journeyman.
I'm still not you the same person. Yeah. Then you, the same
you,
went, person.
You just went 6 rounds with Ozzy Jarvis. Yeah. After you said I sparred those
days. That was a big fight.
I did that. Listen, I've had so much good training. I've had so much good training. I've sparred those days. I sparred Mike Perez. And then you go and put on a 6-round performance like that against Ozzy Jarvis, and you have some guts to tell me
I don't have the same style. What's his gonna make this fight different for you?
He's just gonna see levels.
You're gonna see levels.
We're gonna see, bro. See,
the demons you had.
Someone put you on your ass and knock you out.
Listen, look at this.
You're gonna get them demons.
Look at this side of the table.
You're gonna get them demons.
Olympian, don't you dare talk about
pedigree. You only care about
the
You only went to the Olympics just to show face.
Listen, you don't know what
to show. You only came just to make up numbers.
Can you see Chris Congo there? He was on the GB team, he wants to get to Olympics. So now
Richard over there, you were saying, oh, you wanted to fight him. How come 2 days after you pulled out?
Show me one place where I said I wanted to fight him.
Listen, Tech can bring the text right now, saying, listen, don't lie.
Told me about you and your coach, and Richard is someone who actually I respect as a person.
Yeah, so you don't respect him enough to fight him, though.
Let me go one step further. Look at your coach there, smiling. Look at him, and figure this out. Richard trains in your gym, yeah? And he's ready to give Richard the big money fight. He wanted me to beat Richard, who once again, shout out to Richard. He either wanted me to beat Richard to big up the fight of you, or he expects Richard to beat me, which means he's protecting you. You're fighting me very first and you're gonna get smoked.
Yeah? Okay. I'm gonna punish you, brother.
They're sacrificing their Christmas and New Year's ahead of everyone. But let me ask you, Isaac, prediction. Give me a prediction.
Listen, I'm gonna bust his shark here.
Any rounds?
Right. We have to see from the first 1 to 3 rounds. Yeah, we're gonna see how it goes. Okay. After the first 1 to 3 rounds. Hey, bro,
you want to see where he's at after 1 to 3 rounds, warm up into the fight, and then take it.
We'll see. I'm telling you right now, we'll see. He thinks he's underestimating just because I don't talk too much. But you're the one on Twitter. Shut up. You're the one on Twitter that talks so much. It's going to be a great fight. Isaac, that. Go through my Twitter and yours. And you see who's talking the most. You're talking too much about me. Shut up and do your work, and I'll see you February the 3rd.
Okay, what's your prediction?
The prediction is simple. This goes to who Isaac is as a person, which is going to show in a fight. Is that he's the type of person who needs 100 people around him clapping, telling him, Isaac, you're the best, you can do it.
Okay,
Penny.
He needs to speak to psychiatrists, hypnosis.
This is a real fact. This is who you are as a person to tell you, you can do it, Isaac. I don't need that. So what's going to happen is, everyone's going to get to him. It's going to be you and me. All your game plans, I'm so sick. I'm going to take him to late rounds. You're going to feel shot one. Okay. Shot two. Then it's going to start dawning on you. Oh my God. There's levels. Oh, this actually hurts. And then, everything that you think about later rounds, you might not even see later rounds. Because what really is bad is, you're a human being. And you're a human being. And for you to think somehow, that if I hit you, you're going to be able to rally through and this and that because your shoulder came out. There's a difference between a broken shoulder and a broken jaw, and you're going to find that out in a more vicious way.
You've got to earn that shot, yeah? You've got to earn that shot. You've got to earn that shot first. You see, we'll see how you improve this. You've got to earn that shot first.
This is going to be a great build-up, and I would like to say, although there is British beef, fair play to both these guys, 100%. To the camps as well. They might not be because they believe in themselves, because they want to provide the fans with great fights and great nights of boxing. This is going to be a great fight, a great night of boxing, February the 3rd. Thank you to everyone for coming today, all these fighters.
And sending them back to McDonald's.
Thank you to everyone for coming, the fighters, the boss, I'm in my co-promoter, MC Joshua. We're going to post for photos up here with the guys, head-to-head, and then available for one-on-ones as well. Thank you. We'll see you. Have a great Christmas. Ain't no other sight in the game to see the boxing board.